Good morning. We gather knowing that surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. Join me.
Thank you. those who persecute or betray you, those who are joyful, and those who weep. The author of the epistle letter to the Romans reminds us and invites us to do as Jesus did. Do not be overcome with evil, but overcome evil with good. In the words of Jesus, take up your cross and follow me. This requires that we follow God's way in offering a good meal at God's table for all of God's guests.
Thank you.
crisscross applesauce. What do you think about this table? What table is this? What? The table of God. Like what?
Our scripture reading today is from the book of Romans, chapter 12, verses 9 through 21. Let love be genuine. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not lag in zeal. Be ardent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in suffering and persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the saints. Extend hospitality to strangers. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not claim to be wiser than you are. Do not repay anyone evil for evil, but take thought for what is noble in the sight of all. If it is possible, so far as it depends on you, live peaceably with all. Beloved, never avenge yourselves, but leave room for the wrath of God, for it is written, "Vengeance is mine, I will repay," says the Lord. No, if your enemies are hungry, feed them. If they are thirsty, give them something to drink. For by doing this, you will heap burning coals on their heads. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good.
Strength and our Redeemer. Amen. I enunciate too loudly, I get a tickle. In 1950, a Gallup poll was taken, and one of the questions asked the people was how important the people thought they were. 12% of the population responded by saying that they individually were important. In 2005, Gallup repeated the poll, and this time 80% of the population responded by saying that they thought individually they were important. Society and culture in those two time periods,
the word try. perfectly, but we, like all human institutions, have errors. Our welcome, no matter how well-intentioned and sincere, sometimes falls short. But we do, very intentionally, try to live out these words, and the words, no matter who you are, or where you are on life's journey. You're welcome here. As a result, we have a reputation in town, and not everyone looks at us or our ministries with great favor. John learned the other day that he has a reputation in several churches, and members of our church have been told that John is a false prophet. Now, John's a false prophet because he and we, as a church, welcome everyone into our church. Everyone. No member of this church has more rights or less rights than anyone else. Paul, who may have been divorced and want to be remarried, people who may have been divorced and want to be remarried are welcome at our table and welcome to be remarried in our church. We have same-gendered couples in our church. You are listening to one now. We have people who have been married in our church. We do not limit the rights of gay people in the least. But we have a bizarre notion about children as well. You never hear us talking about the kids being the future of our church. Our children are part of the church, right here and right now. They are a part of the present, here and now. And at St. Mark's, we do have a health fair, clothes closet, soup kitchen, etc. We have all sorts of people wandering through our building. And because John, as the senior pastor of this church, supports all of our extravagant hospitality, some folks think that makes him a false prophet. I say, if this be the case, then so be it. When people look at us, and they look at St. Mark's, at our derogatory, and say we are a church of misfits, and our extravagant hospitality is, well, a bit too extravagant, there's a reason. People are being excluded at churches. Many people are here in part of St. Mark's because no one else really wanted them or accepted them or were willing to love them. We were. We are. We are the church that has tried to rejoice. Be patient with the suffering of others. We have tried to rejoice with those who rejoice and weep with those who weep. We do not claim to be wiser than they are. We claim to be pilgrims on a journey. And if other churches aren't doing this, well, someone has to. Someone has to, and that someone, right now, it's us. Secondly, Paul is talking vividly about compassion. As people who strive to walk with Jesus, every day we have an opportunity to share the love and compassion of Christ with people. The core of the gospel is love and compassion. It's about God's love for people. lived out in Jesus. The love God has for people, we gather from the New Testament, is overwhelming. It's so overwhelming that it's perhaps incomprehensible. And it's genuine. Our scripture today begins with the words, "Let love be genuine." And then he goes on to tell us what genuine love is. And underpinning all of this is compassion. It is people walking together and loving one another, to hurt with others as we carry along with others on their journey. Like many people, we have been transfixed by the images in Texas this week. The devastation of Hurricane Harvey and the rain has been incredible. The storm has brought the Houston area more than 3 to 4 days. The storm has brought the Houston area more rain in 3 to 4 days than we typically have in a year. In the Houston area, 52 inches of rain has fallen, the most ever recorded on our continent. There has been death, destruction, and stories of great compassion. It is often said that tragedies bring out the best in people, and this certainly has. In the coming months and years, long after the press coverage is over, people will still be rebuilding. The people of the country, the people of churches, will be given the opportunity to be part of the rebuilding. There are going to be plans from our Conference of the United Church of Christ to send people from our churches to assist. And I hope we are part of that, because part of coming to the table is going forth from the table, nourished and ready to love God's people more fully. Our worship series begins today with "Come to the Table." On the table in front of you, you're going to use it.
Sorry. This part is very personal to me. Our worship series begins with "Come to the Table." And on the table in front of me, there are chalices. One is blue. It was given to me by my parents for ordination. One chalice is made of old air conditioner parts. It's not usable, but I worked in an air conditioning shop during summer jobs. And when I was being ordained, they gave me that as a gift. One chalice, the tan one, was given to me by my wife out of love. Another chalice, the blue one, I bought at an education event. There is one that was found in the cabinet of my study. These are diverse, and all of them are treasured. They're sort of like us. They're sort of like our church. We are diverse, but we love each other and are loved by God. In a few moments, when we have communion, you'll be invited to come to the table. Come to the table knowing that you are loved by God more than any of us can possibly have. Amen. Harvey Bishop.
Fisher's friend Sandra Ayers, for Susan Vincent. We pray for the family of Kurt Smolik. Sally Lesnander had outpatient surgery this week and is home and recovering. We pray for all the victims of Hurricane Harvey and for all the people who are helping with the cleanup. We pray for people in India, Bangladesh, and Nepal. They too have been not dealing with the storm and great flooding. And 1,200 people at this point are dead, and 41 million people have been impacted by the flooding. Also, we pray there's another hurricane off the coast, Hurricane Irma. We pray for all people who are possibly in the path. Are there other people you'd like us to pray for? Yes. Susan is home. Okay. But she's home and doing well. Good. Susan Vincent is home and doing well. Some joys. Our worship team has worked diligently to bring a new theme, and you can tell by the decor, they worked really hard. And there's going to be a different kind of theme set up every week we come to church. It's going to match the theme, so I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful for all the people who are here today, and I'm really grateful it stopped raining. Because I was really concerned about our rocking the block. It'll be really neat to be outside listening to it, and I'm sure it'll be really neat inside, but really loud inside. Other people, yes?
My mother and father celebrated 39 years of marriage yesterday.
Very good. Your mother and father celebrated 39 years of marriage. Congratulations to them. Yes? Molly Nola's back after knee replacement surgery. You're doing well. Yes.
A young man I know is going to be able to work for a couple of months for an emergency renovation company. Okay. And he and his family put out a call. There are some supplies that he needs, and I'd love to be ready to place him on the
list. Let us pray in the silence of our hearts for all those things we are doing. generously carry as we share our offering together.
Oh.
choice to empathize and to live peacefully. Please guide us as we reach out to others so that they can see and feel your love through our actions. In your name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Sandy.
For the times when our love is not genuine, Lord, have mercy on us.
For the times when we do not love one another with mutual affection,
Christ, have mercy on us.
For the times we fail to show honor to our sisters and brothers,
Lord, have mercy on us.
When we try to overcome evil with evil,
Christ, have mercy on us.
For all these times when we fail and fall short of God's glory,
we are forgiven by the grace and love of God.
My friends, God is ever present with you.
And the people say, and also with you.
And also with you.
Turn to the people around you and tell them the news. The peace of Christ is with you always.
The peace of Christ. Listen, the body breathes in together and out. As close as breath, the Holy is present with us. So we lift up our hearts, and the family says, we lift them up to God.
Give thanks to the living one, because it is the right thing to do. Not only now, but always. Not always now, but always when God is with us.
I invite you to open both palms upward in sign language for you.
We thank you, Creator God, that you have formed us in your image.
Now place your hands together in the sign meaning to be with.
We thank you, Sustainer God, you are here with us.
And bring your hands close to your face in a sign for prayer. Close your eyes and become aware of your breath on your hands.
We thank you, God, for breathing into us the breath of life, even when we have turned away. Have remained with us, close as breath. When we have been frightened, hesitant, still you are patient. You have time and again reached out your hand to free us, for your promise is steadfast.
And so we open our eyes, our hands, and our hearts to your will for us, as told to us through your prophets. We join our voices together, praising you along with all who do. Ever done so and ever will do so, repeating, Holy, Holy, Holy God.
Holy, Holy, Holy God.
Everywhere we see your glory.
Everywhere we see your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest.
And the widest.
And the widest.
And the deepest.
And the deepest.
Core of our being.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of God. Blessed is your Son who came to preach the good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives, and recovery of sight to the blind, to set liberty those who are oppressed, and to announce that the time has come when we save your people.
Listen, people. The Lord is with you. He healed the sick and the hungry, and sat down at the table and ate with especially those others considered unworthy. Let us remind ourselves by saying, the Lord is present with every one of us.
The Lord is present with every one of us. On the night Jesus gave himself up, he took bread, gave you thanks, and broke the bread, and gave it to the disciples and said, take this, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me.
covenant poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me.
Let us be a community of messengers, proclaiming and reminding each other and creation that Christ has died.
Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again.
Christ will come again.
I invite you to raise your hands in the ancient Christian posture of prayer.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here, and on these gifts of bread and wine. Let them be for us the body and blood of Christ, so that we may be for the world the body of Christ, liberated by his witness, passion, and life. Be with us, Holy Spirit. Fill us and move through us.
Now I invite you to make a point of connection with those around you by laying a hand on a shoulder, holding hands, or whatever is most comfortable for you.
In the Spirit, we are one with Christ, the host of this table, and one with each other. Let this joy be seen in us outside this place. With great thanks, all God people say, Amen. Amen. Come to God's table, all is now ready.
Thank you. about what the soul is, and it's good to see things and all that.